Morning, Whackhead.
Good morning, sir. I was... an interview was thrust upon me.
Yeah, well, you see, it was because the rest of us were actually on air at the time, and it was one time we could get with Lionel Richie, so I've, with trepidation...
Trepidation.
I said, Whackhead, just handle this.
No, but don't, sir, don't be like that. I mean, I've interviewed some greats like James Blunt as Whackhead in the morning.
You've cocked up some interviews with some greats.
Oh, but you've got to admit they were pearlers. But this time, luckily enough, I didn't have time to do my whole Whackhead in the morning thing.
Good.
So I did a straight interview. And in hindsight, I am so thankful that I did. Because I've never met a nicer man than Lionel Richie.
Darren.
Is this Mr. Lionel Richie?
Listen, live and in living color.
How are you today, sir?
Are you kidding me, man? Listen, the only thing is I can't do anymore. Life is just too good. And for my music to still be playing after all these years, life is great.
Now, where about are you in the world right now?
I'm actually, believe it or not, I'm at home.
Is Nicole, does she stay with you or down the road?
She comes by at least once a day or every other day with my brand new heart, Harlow, the baby.
Now that you've become a grandfather, do you feel like, oh, now I'm actually old?
No, you know what it is? I thought, believe it or not, when she said, Dad, you're going to be a grandfather, I must tell you, there was a side of me that said, oh, well, there goes my sexy. But all of a sudden now, I cannot tell you how many girls run up to me and go, oh, my God, you're Nicole, you're Harlow's granddad. And I'm going, I never felt more sexy in my life because Grandpa's working out real well here. I'm working out pretty good here, babe.
So is Paris Hilton a bit of a hanger-on at your house?
We had dinner on Sunday. Paris and Nicole and Joel and everybody went out for dinner at the Polo Club. And all I can tell you is that it's almost surreal because, you know, they've all kind of grown up a little bit here. But at the same time, they are just as silly as the day I first met them all. You know, it's just the next generation of crazy, wonderful parents, you know.
Now, with Nicole's hectic potty schedule that we see in the magazines all the time, have you become the glorified babysitter?
Now, of course, you know I have to tease her every 5 minutes, right? So I go, okay, Joel and Nicole, leave the baby with me, and I'm going to take the baby to the club. And she looks at me and goes, Dad, you can't take the baby to the restaurant, to the club. And I go, well, Paris wanted to take Miles, my son. You wanted to take him to the club when he was only 2 years old.
And I'm glad she hasn't fallen into the trap like Paris by making these home movies.
No, thank God. Listen, the only reason I'm still alive today is that she missed the whole movie. Thank you very much, God.
Because, I mean, Britney Spears is one coming out. It seems to be the fashion in Hollywood at the moment.
No. Tell me Britney does not have one coming out.
She has one. The paparazzi dude that she was dating before has made a movie. Apparently, oh. she's in nothing but a pink wig.
Oh, God. Mm. Well, it's either going to do one of two things. It's either going to make her more famous than she's ever been in life, or it's going to make her really, really famous than she's ever been. There's no downside. You know what's so wonderful now is things that used to ruin your career ago, 20 years ago, are now the reason people get famous now.
Exactly. I mean, there's people that are famous for just being famous.
Exactly.
Yeah.
When Nicole came to me and Paris came to me and she said, they gave us our own television show. And my answer was, oh, I'm so happy. What characters are you going to play? And they said, we play two rich, spoiled girls who are going to live off their parents' money forever. And I said, oh, that's wonderful. I said, you guys can play that very well. She said, oh, yeah, by the way, Dad, it's a reality television show.
And
I almost had a nervous breakdown. Say you, say
Lionel Richie.
What a nice guy.
The Awakening. Darren had a long, long chat to him, so we'll play you bits and pieces of that throughout the rest of the hour.